Hey, this is the Swedish Guitar Nerd, and you're watching Nerd News. In today's episode of Nerd News, I'm talking about Traveler Guitar's Vaibrant models. I think the first time I saw a guitar from Traveler Guitar was in an airport in Paris, actually. They were selling it in the tax-free section, and I think that's how Traveler Guitars are marketing their guitars, because it's all kinds. It's electrics, acoustics, but the general idea is that you are supposed to be able to bring it on the plane or wherever you're traveling, and they've stripped away all the unnecessary parts of the guitars, basically. And, they've worked together with other companies, I think, because they made a LTD model that's like a single-cut Les Paul-style guitar that must in some way have been done in connection to ESP. And they also made the Travel Caster, which is basically the pickguard guitars from, again, ESP or Grassroots in that case. So it's very similar guitar where it's basically only the pickguard of a Strat and everything else is carved away. And the headstock, which on the Grassroots model was kind of the normal size. On the Traveler Guitars version, it was smaller as well. And now they have made something new based on that concept. It's the Vaibrant, and that's V-A-I, as in Joe Satriani? No, as in someone else. And I'm not sure if they have done this in cooperation with a big Japanese company. So buy them while you can, I suppose. They are very, very similar to the models that certain guitarist created together with that Japanese company. I won't mention any name. Starts with I, ends with Ness. They are really good looking. They are looking like those models. It's really fancy colors. There are two versions of it. They both share 24 frets. They all both have Floyd Rose tremolos. They both have HSS, that's a humbucker in the neck, a single coil in the middle, and a humbucker at the bridge as well. And they have the exact same pickup configuration or five-way switch where you split the coils as with the other guitar from that Japanese company. They are, again, exactly like the Japanese company's versions. There's the deluxe one, and that very much looks like the original 11, even has the neck inlays and the color scheme of the pickups compared to the guitar and everything. It's it's very similar, and this is much like the Travel Caster. So it's basically just the pickguard and everything else is shaved off from the body, and the headstock is kind of smaller as well, but otherwise it's a full-scale guitar. It's a 25 and a half inch guitar neck, so it's the full fat. And as I said, they have the deluxe version and they also have the standard version. And speaking of the standard version, this is a true story, I was contacted by a company and they wondered if I was interested in endorsing their products. And I replied this way: well, if you make a guitar that's in hot pink, where all the hardware is black, and the fretboard is maple, and it has a Floyd Rose, sure, I'll endorse your products. Well, it wasn't Traveler Guitar, because they have this model. So, I don't know if my email leaked somewhere. So, Traveler Guitar, if you're interested in some kind of endorsement, I guess you can contact me, because that's the exact guitar I wanted. So that's the standard models. They have the V88X, that's the deluxe version, and they have the V88S, that's the standard version. And it's supposed to be fancy pickups in the deluxe one, and of course more standard versions of the pickups in the standard one. The deluxe has Floyd Rose 1000 tremolos, and that's the basically the regular Floyd Royces, only that they're made in the Far East. And the standard has a Floyd Rose special, so that's a bit lower in quality. So that's the Vaibrant from Travel Guitars this week's spotlight. Yeah, if you're interested in having your products covered in Nerd News or in any way you want to comment my videos, please leave a comment or send an email to this address. And next week I'll be back talking about a multi-effect pedal, I think. We'll see. So see you soon. Bye.